You might hear about new discoveries being made every day. You wake up every morning, read the headlines, and find out that every other day an esuch discovery is being made in the space exploration field. Space exploration and colonization of Mars has been on the tongue of every other person, but there are other discoveries too that are not made in the space exploration field. Many revelations were made in the water too. What were these discoveries? What impact did they have for us and our future? How are these discoveries made? Continue watching the video till the end to know more. Hey everyone, and welcome back to yet another video from our channel. I hope you guys are doing extremely well. In this video, we will be looking into the discoveries made in the water. We will be doing a deep dive into each and every aspect of these discoveries. So if you are new to this channel, then do make sure to hit the subscribe button. Now, without any further ado, let's hop right into the video. Of all the amazing discoveries being made every day all around the world, my favorite ones have got to be those that emerge from the beds of the ocean. There happens to be something that captures our very own imagination and intrigues our own curiosity as to what else lies underneath the surface. Just the idea of an entire city that might be hidden beneath the surface of the ocean is just unimaginable. With the technological advancements being made year after year, more and more finding and discoveries are being made in this field. We have curated a list of extremely remarkable discoveries that have captured our imagination, so let's now have a look into it. Number 1. The artifacts retrieved from the site of the first ever ancient naval battle. Back in November 2013, when archaeologists announced the recovery of a treasure trove of artifacts off the coast of Sicily from the site of the first ancient naval battle ever discovered, including battering rams, helmets, armor, and weapons dating back to around 2,000 years. There are the remainings of the Battle of Igadi Island, which was found out to be the last clash from the First Punic War, which took place in 241 BC, wherein the Romans fought the Carthaginians in a battle that culminated from more than 20 years of warring as the Romans struggled to gain a foothold in the Mediterranean Sea. Meanwhile, these Carthaginians were much more powerful on the water. The Romans lay in wait, trapping the Carthaginians and blocking off their own sea route in a sudden but violent attack. Around 50 Carthaginian ships were sunk, killing up to 10,000 men. The Roman victory set them on the road for Europe-wide domination. This priceless hoarder of artifacts had lain undisturbed on the seabed at a depth of around 100 meters for more than 2 millennia. Moving on to number 2, we have the 2,000-year-old intact Roman medicinal pill found in the submerged shipping vessel. Back in summer of 2013, a group of Italian scientists conducted a chemical analysis on some ancient Romanian medicinal pills, which was discovered in the Relitto del Pozzino, a 2,000-year-old submerged shipping vessel which sank off the coast of Tuscany. This revealed what exactly the ancient Romans used as medicine. The Roman shipwreck lay near the remains of the Etruscan city of Popolonia, which at the time the ship foundered Wawa, a key port along sea trade routes between the west and the east across the Mediterranean Sea. The Relitto del Pozzino was then excavated by the Archaeological Superintendency of Tuscany throughout the 1980s and 90s, which revealed a variety of fascinating cargo, including the lamps originating in Asia Minor, Syrian-Palestinian glass bowls, bronze jug, ceramic vessels which were then used for containing and carrying wines, and of particular interest, the remains of a medicine chest containing a surgery hook, a mortar, 136 wooden drug vials, and a number of circular medicinal tablets. These tin containers had remained completely sealed, which then kept the pill dry, providing an amazing opportunity to find out what exactly was contained inside of them. The results then revealed that the pills inside of them contained a number of organic and non-organic compounds like zinc compounds, as well as iron oxide, starch, beeswax, pine resin, and other plant-derived materials. Next up, number 3, we have the mysterious 10,000-years-old underwater ruins in Japan. On the southern coast of Yonaguni, Japan, lay submerged ruins which are estimated to be around 10,000 years old. The origin of the site is hotly debated upon. Many experts have debated amongst themselves that it is man-made, whereas the other scientists insist it was carved out by natural phenomena. The unique and awe-inspiring site was discovered in 1995 by a diver who strayed too far off the Okinawa shore and was dumbstruck when he stumbled upon the sunken arrangement of monolithic blocks as if terraced into the side of a mountain. This site consists of a huge stone block which fits around perfectly at right-angled joints, carvings, and what appears to be stairways, paved streets, crossroads, and plazas. Apart from these unusual features displayed at the Yonaguni, there remains some scientists, such as geologist Robert Schock of Boston University, who is reported to be studying the formation and who are adamant that the large blocks form naturally as a result of tectonic movement. Number 4, the most eerie one from our list. the perfectly preserved ancient Chinese underwater city, the Lion City. You might have heard of this, right? Also known as Xicheng, it is an ancient submerged city that lies at the foot of Wuxi Mountain, which is located beneath the spectacular Qiandao Lake of China. The officials have taken a renewed interest in the sunken city since discovering it back in February this year, and despite of this, more than 50 years underwater, the entire city has been preserved completely intact, transforming it into a virtual time capsule. The Lion City was built during the Eastern Han Dynasty and was supposed to be once the center of politics and economics in the eastern province of Zhejiang. But then, back in 1959, the Chinese government had decided that a new hydroelectric power station was required. Therefore, it built a man-made lake, submerging Xicheng under 40 meters of water. The Lion City lay undisturbed and forgotten for 53 years until Qiu Feng, a local official in charge of tourism, decided to see what remained of the city under the deep waters. He was also amazed by discovering that, protected from wind, rain, and sun, the entire city, complete with temples, memorial arches, paved roads, and houses, was completely intact, including wooden beams and stairs. Now, number 5. Deep within the ocean off the coast of Tahiti, scientists made an incredible discovery back in November. Acres of giant, pristine, rose-shaped coral blooming from within the seafloor in what is known as the ocean's twilight zone. A coral reef, so large and so beautiful, had yet to be discovered emphasizes how little we still know about the world's oceans, according to the scientists. And its impeccable condition, with no strong such evidence to support that the reef has yet been harmed by the climate crisis, suggests that the need for urgent action to protect the oceans remaining healthy reefs. The team of international divers claimed that the reef, which stretched as far as the eye can see, was magical to witness. It's like a work of art, claimed by the team lead. A research mission led by UNESCO found out that the reef stretches around 2 miles and exists at depths down to 70 meters or around 230 feet. This is around the ocean's twilight zone, where there's just enough light to sustain life, and below this, the ocean transitions into a dark abyss. For once, it's a positive story about coral reefs in the news, which is quite rare these days, said the head of marine policy at UNESCO. Warming oceans and acidification caused by the climate crisis have led to widespread coral bleaching. Last year, scientists found the global extent of living coral has declined by half since 1950 due to climate change, overfishing, and pollution. The discovery suggests that there are, in fact, many more large reefs out in our ocean at depths of more than 30 meters, which have not been mapped. They said, it's quite a puzzling finding. Only around 20% of the ocean floor has so far been mapped, according to UNESCO, and until its latest discovery, the vast majority of the planet's known coral ecosystems were believed to extend to a depth of just 25 meters, illustrating how much of the ocean still needs to be explored. Do you think more of such coral reefs will be discovered in the near future? Is there another Lion City that could be revealed in the future? Did we miss out on any such discoveries? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section down below. We would love to hear your thoughts on this while we keep working on making more such videos. Well, that brings us to the end of this video. We hope you have enjoyed watching the video. Please like the video if you have not already, and make sure to hit the subscribe button. Don't forget to press the bell icon to never miss another update from our channel. With that being said, let's meet in another one of these videos. Until then, see ya!